when I was collecting my records, and of course we had some talks with the record shops, my friends, you needed some kind of documentary to have some kind of registration of the songs that you have, the vinyls that you have bought. And I was thinking, why not compile, just for me, for myself, a folio with all my records popular in that day of summertime or springtime or whatever. And what's the new entry was a record that I bought the other day, just a week before. So it was just a funny chart, not really professional whatever, but I tried to make it as beautiful as possible. And it was like 20 records, 20 posts, 20 songs, and I thought, okay, 20, yeah, it sounds okay, but it's missing something, of course. And I didn't want to have something like a cheap name of the cappuccino chart or the pizza chart. I was thinking, okay, this could be something maybe like the national color of Italy is azzurro, 20 d'azzurro. Yeah, yeah, it sounds okay. So I checked with an Italian guy in the restaurant, what do you think about the name 20 d'azzurro? Is it a stupid name? Because I think it's beautiful. And he said, no, keep it, it's beautiful too. So that was the beginning of 20 d'azzurro. And I started my charts in 84, and officially I came out with the songs like printed paper for record shops in 86. January 86 was the first of the official edition on the in the record shop.